Yeah, we're doing this thing. We gone wild. Magadiga depends. Kubu Island, Dumaka, Moremi.
Chesa.
It's on. They are not ready for us.
Can't wait to drive on the pens, man.
Yeah. Gonna be interesting because they are wet. Gonna be a wet and wild, muddy day.
Yeah, we'll be recovering Hiluxes and Rangers, eh?
I'm feeling that you must convince me it wasn't a setup.
But it wasn't a setup.
We are slowly towing him to wherever. We'll see where we get. I'm with my brothers here from Meerkat Squad.
Living life every day, late at night, not okay. All I want, and I pray, all I need are some better days. Yeah, all I need are some better days. Cause all I want, and I pray, I believe.
Botswana, a truly beautiful place that's filled with its natural beauty and all its ways. It's a place that scientists will call the origin of the human species. And here we are to explore the motherland and see its beauty. We made a quick stop at Palapi to stock up cheap supplies. After a short stop in Khabroni to pick up Tlamelo, one of our travel buddies. Made a few friends on the outside who were interested in what we were doing and the journey that we are about to take.
Hey, okay, let's go.
Yeah, we're doing this thing. We gone wild, sorting out SIM cards, local SIM cards. Magadiga depends. Kubu Island, Dumaka, Moremi.
Chesa.
It's on. They are not ready for us.
June, here we come.
They are not ready for us. It's on.
Can't wait to drive on the pens, man.
Gonna be interesting because they are wet. Gonna be a wet and wild, muddy day.
Yeah, that's true.
We can't have it any better.
Yeah, we'll be recovering Hiluxes and Rangers, eh?
We must make sure that the camera captures everything. It mustn't be selective.
We then made our way to Makadikadi National Park using the Kumapa Gate, where we crossed the river using the ferry.
We're here, location!
While this is not by design a holiday, but more of it's an expedition trip to just check. So game viewing, enjoying the place and just exploring properly is not something that we're doing. Just being able to do a bucket list item like crossing the Butete River using a ferry, it was something magical and wonderful to experience. And so here we are. We feel very much privileged and honored to be able to do this today. The ferry costs about 150 pula to cross to the one side. The process takes about, say, 5 minutes, and you are through to the other side and you enter the national park. We We arrived at our campsite around 8 o'clock in the evening, and that light was still visible.
This is two. Yeah. It's fine. I think it's nice. So, nice and neat.
Yeah.
How do we park?
Campsite 2 was quite good and spacious. We could fit all three vehicles in there. We camped quite tightly and close because all the vehicles carry different things. So I would guess that the normal camping setup would allow maybe two vehicles and a trailer to be comfortable. Started making dinner.
Step 1, wake up early, gonna rise with the sun. Step 2, get some good, some food in you. Step 3, think real hard about what you wanna be. Step 4, everybody just do your thing.
Wake up, today's gonna be a good day. Wake up,
today's gonna be waking up in Mahadikhadi National Park. We got here yesterday at the Kumaha Wilderness Camp. I got here a bit late, set up camp in the dark, and working lights did quite well to help us set up. And just quite a long drive to come here. Right? I think people take it light of how far it gets to come to up north of Botswana. We spent most of the day on the road to come up here. We had to wake up early. But yeah, we've arrived, and we want to trail and check the spaces that we're going to be camping in June, where we bring everybody to come with. So we decided it's wise of us to come and just experience it ourselves, and just make sure that everything is fine in anticipation of a few other people that will be joining us. Yeah, this is our campsite. Look at the sun that's coming through. You know, the little times that we can get as holiday time, to get a few 1 or 2 days leave, just come and experience this and wake up in the sounds of nature. Sometimes we rush to the holiday destinations where we go, and it's a lot of people, there's a lot of noise, and if you know that doesn't suit you and you want a bit of nature as an alternative, and wake up to the birds singing, to the baboons, just the general bush sounds and melodies, this for me does it. This for me does the trick. Today the plans are to go to Nxaipan, drive around, see Bain's Baba, and then shoot to Maun, and then do Moremi. We're going to sleep in at Moremi Fed Bridge. We also want to check a few community sites, camping sites, and just get a feel for everything in anticipation for the June trip. So this is not a holiday, it's just maybe more of an expedition trip to check. We're sent by the administration team of Meerkat. Meerkat Squad to come check this. So, yeah, excellent. The campsite is located quite close to the river and has got good ablutions that are well kept and got warm water through a solar geyser. Ours was not a game viewing trip.
How far is the other way?
Should I can go?
Don't rush.
Well, there's like four that I see.
The park offers some good game viewing opportunities, as it didn't take much that we saw quite a bit of game around the route, which would make great viewing. So definitely a place to come back to and enjoy.
Yeah, just stop you there. There's something hooking your rear wheel. Let's remove the thing.
Wildy. They don't call me Dagon Wild for nothing. Always Wildy.
This is what it is. This is what it is.
Wildy, you know. Let's go.
Your clearance, what's the millimeters here? So anything smaller will struggle here. Look at your diff sitting on the very close to the sand.
Well, that I'm saying is the so this middle, this part, is very high. It is very high. So even if you don't have a 4x4 and it's not raised, you will struggle.
You're asking for trouble.
My bike high is hard. Look at that. So
we made our way up until the Pungkut Gate, where we exited the Makadikad National Park, and they said we had to shoot to the left, going to Maun, and to the right, going towards Nxaipan. Want to see the famous Baines Baobab. Baines Baobab are a cluster of baobab trees that apparently were discovered by some fellow called Thomas Baines a couple of years
In Nxaipan, through a local pen into Baines Baobab. So it shows that people have tried to cross over because of the recent rains that have poured down. The rain, I think, only stopped on Saturday, which is 2 days back. So I don't know when these guys tried to cross here, but you can see it never worked out. They just bogged down and kept on bogging. Yeah, we made it to Baines Baobab. It's quite a drive. It took us an hour to get to here. And we should just go just to the baobab tree there. We would like to just take some shots and just see what it's about. But I think this is more drivable. Lesego, one of our travel buddies, has an issue with the charging of his batteries. Yesterday he had to stop there by Sorowe to get his battery replaced, which was flat. So he's gone now ahead of us to Maun. So from Makgadikgadi Pans, from Boteti, we took a left for about 125 or so k's. Then there's a right turn to this side, which is the Nxaipan, where we are. Here about Nxaipan, Baines Baobab. Here we are. Just in the middle of the pens. So we hear Meerkat Squad is here. The delegation of Meerkat Squad. We are here to inspect the land. I'm with Tlamelo and Judah. And we're here to do what we do, do what we love. There's other guys here from another country, I'm not sure which country we're from. I'm going to just be good to have a chat with them and then see where they're from. They say here they have this hired vehicle, Yeah. Can I come there with my camera?
Yeah.
How are you? Where are you guys from?
Germany.
Germany? Oh, okay. I've been to Munich. What year was it? 2015?
Okay.
Yeah, I was there 2015. I was for the. Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I went to the BMW tour, but I was there for the IFAT conference, that exhibition.
Okay.
IFAT. At the big. In Munich, man, they used to have it there with all the industrial Chinese, everybody would be coming there.
Production?
Yeah, yeah, IFAT conference, it was at the convention center.
Yeah, ah, okay, not, yes. Not on the. On the.
Exactly.
Now, the big area outside Munich? No, it's.
No, it was within
yeah,
Munich, yeah. Munich,
yeah. Yeah,
we drove to, and I also drove on the Autobahn there with my South African license. But anyway.
You're allowed to drive?
Yeah. I don't know if
you're
I was.
Fast. You were fast.
No.
Yeah?
I just wanted the experience of the
Autobahn.
Of the Autobahn, yeah.
There should be music, man. There should be music. I can't be driving in silence. I'm driving in Germany.
Driving in Munich. With his Munich shirt on.
Yeah.
Maybe distracted. No. You control. Two oh three. Break. Oh, 203.
Autobahn. Germany.
Otherwise, you drive fast there?
No, if I can't.
And you're allowed to drive. As a foreigner, you're always a kind of.
Yeah, no, I was with an English friend of mine who had an international license.
Ah, okay.
So I was driving. He's from the UK.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. Hey, good, nice to meet you.
Yes,
yeah, we do this. Yeah, we're going now to Maun, to Moremi.
Yeah, we're going.
We're going there as well, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright.
Where, huh?
Where are you guys camping today?
No, we're not camping, we're in a lodge.
Oh, okay. Ah, no, we camp. So we sit on those.
You have to go in Moremi now today? No.
We hope so. That's why he's in a rush. He wants us to get going.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, guys.
One picture.
No, we will do. Thank you. Yes, together.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, we can do that. We can do that. You want a picture with your phone or with.
Yeah.
Okay.
Nxaipan National Park is a vast piece of land stretching about 2,500 square kilometers. It's a place of fascinating landscapes with the attraction of a group of baobab trees, which are famously named Bain's Baobab. And they also have a main attraction for waterhole, which frequents quite a number of game life that has made the park its home. The park derives its name from San language, from the Bushmen. It was named after a stick called Nga, which the Bushmen used to use as a digging tool. And this is where the name comes from. It's now in the late afternoon and we're making our way to Maun, where we'll link up with Lesego. Looks like we'll camp at the Audi camp in Maun. We just made a turn from Maun all the way to Moremi. The big test now is a suspension, is an Ironman Foam Cell Pro suspension. This gravel road will be the test of it all. This is the ultimate test, at least for now. Tell you guys how it's doing. This is today the longest gravel road that we'll be on. So this is another test that we have going on. I'm here, Meerkat Squad, Stivoski Africa, Daki Gone Wild, Sekhos the Adventurer, accompanied by Tlamelo, our companion from Botswana. And we're about to hit the road. Start your choppers. We're doing about 60
kilos per hour on the stretch of road, which it recently rained probably 3-8 days ago. So there's some puddles of water here and there, but the ride is quite smooth. The corrugations are not that bad. So, well, you've got some, but you barely feel them with deflated tires. Suspension really does its work. The diameter of this, that's foam cell pros, is 65 millimeter diameter. They're a bit heavy, they've got quite a bit of oil, as it adds to the weight of the vehicle, but for the kind of ride quality gain that you get, I think it is definitely worth it. But so far, impressive stuff. The ride quality is definitely better than the previous suspension I had on. It's just a slight improvement.
Sorry, guys. Yeah. Taking the suspension, and it's working. Smooth and bound higher.
Yeah, I know. If we had anyone with any other suspension here, I wonder if they would appreciate what you are doing.
You must get the proper review, so I'm making sure you've got content.
You know your team very well. Yes, Judah, all good, all good. Happiness. I feel we are going too slow, man. Yeah, I wanna test this suspension. I wanna fly through some of these things. So yourself, how is it doing? How are you?
I'm good.
Yeah, no, Judah, you hear? There's consensus, man. The speed is too low for these corrugations. They are too comfortable. Yeah, no. If anyone says suspension doesn't do anything, they don't know what they're talking about. I am taking it. Nah, there's the last one. Okay, that's the last time. But you see, I'm getting my car dirty, gents. Yeah, man. But anyway, I'm sure June will be good. Judah, I'm slowing down. You should pass. They go back happy people. There's no way you can come here and be miserable. Unless you've got bad suspension. Arrival at Moremi Game Reserve. What a drive. That's a squad. Meerkat Squad.
I'm going for low gents, running water in front.
As we're checking in the Moremi, we were informed that the park has flooded and generally all the roads are inaccessible. Campsites we want to visit are also inaccessible. So we had a guide who was needed to go from Southgate to Second Bridge, and we offered to take him all the way so that we just see and experience the park itself. But this was not in any way a game viewing experience.
We stopped here in the middle of Moremi on our way to Second Bridge. This horse's rear wheel carrier has just sheared off and fell down. So we've picked it up. Fortunately, Pick saw it in time. Picked it up and we're strapping it on the roof right here. This is how hectic the drive is. Everything is okay, but you know, it gets tested. Everything gets tested proper. Strapping it, trying to stabilize it on the roof rack. So one of the safety features is to, when something like this happens, is to switch off the engines so that we can hear any movement through the bush, any twigs, any trees moving and things like that. So I'm on the lookout as I'm recording this. So this is wilding. Is it secure?
Yes.
Where you strapped it? How is it looking?
No, we just had to tighten the.
Where did you tighten? Holder. We tightened the mugaimo.
The port holder.
On the other side.
Yes, on the port holder, then this side on the roof rack.
Oh.
So should be fine. First of all, the I need to.
Yes, Judo.
I was suggesting that I proceed, but it's only 4 kilometers. And then you guys can follow, or I can find you back here.
The issue would be the different roads that we would take. There would be might be a likelihood of getting lost. We are almost done. It's strapped on, so
the one inside,
a few 1 minute or so, we should be out.
Okay, but right before this, there's no more price for deviation anymore. But fine, I'll allow it.
Oh, if there's no more deviations and branches, then it's fine. Then you can proceed. That would be the only concern.
We are fine. We are
done. Yeah, I just keep on raising low because it's only 4 kilometers.
All right. Yeah, cool. All right. You can shoot. It will help us with time.
Yeah.
Anyway, we are done. Tlamelo, let's go. Okay, we're coming. Dagi gone wild, you are wilding.
Ah.
Yeah? When are you going to stop Dagi gone wild? This is Second Bridge. There's a giraffe looking at us.
Hello, giraffe.
Let's hope there's no one else looking at us.
Otherwise, you gotta learn how to run.
Here's the water at second bridge, the Okovango water. I need to just dip my. I hope there are no crocodiles here. Huh?
They snatch you, you snatch them back. That's how you deal with them.
My goodness. Marupingwa boelwa.
Just so we.
This is home. Huh? In the water of the Okavango Delta. Look at that. It's... No, man. The water of the Okavango.
Blessings.
My goodness.
It's pity we couldn't cross.
Yeah,
we can't. The bridge is damaged.
The bridge is gone.
This is where our road ends.
he's gone there. This one and that. Did you organize someone that side?
People are coming from that side to come fetch you.
Oh. So we have to wait for them in actual fact. No. So we leave him here.
It's like you are illegal immigrant to my brother.
What are you doing here from Angola? Bring the young Bruce.
We're now making our way back to the gate, and the road just getting more and more interesting.
Chuguru.
Come on.
Chuguru.
Yes!
He's
coming out. He's coming out. He made it.
Did he?
He made it. He's stuck.
You know, this one is stuck a bit.
No! I think pull it, yeah.
Maybe put the winch.
Yeah. With
a winch.
Or stuck.
This is the last thing we needed.
Someone must always be on the lookout. Cameraman.
Yeah, I'm on the lookout.
Guys, we should try winch as well.
Yeah.
Take me back to a place where I felt at home. Take me back to a day when we weren't alone. Take me back to an age when we were
not back before.
Take me back to a place where I felt at home. Take me back to a day when we weren't alone. Take me back to an age when
we were not alone. Take me back to an age when we were not alone.
To people putting up walls, I feel like I'm on the left side. Bump on the right.
Eyes on the road.
Thirty flames, you walk among Delta Moraine. That time was poor.
And you on the right.
check if we need to sign out.
Okay, so we can park in the middle so that we can attend to that fire.
Yeah, park that side.
What a hectic drive. Unfortunately, I've got a bit of an issue here. Look at that. So I've got a crack 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've got 1, 2, 3 that are holding the tire together. I'm in Moremi in Botswana. Had I not noticed this in time, yeah, you can just imagine what would happen. Fully loaded, driving on gravel. So it's good to check these things from time to time and just make sure that you don't have this, otherwise this could result in something tragic. So we're about to do replace the spare wheel. How's your day?
It's good.
You're good, yeah.
Set me up there, man.
No, man, don't feel that way. You know us. You know very well. You know very well how we are. You know we would never do that. You mustn't even take your mind there. You know that.
Then I'm feeling that way. You must convince me it wasn't a setup. You
and I. No, but it wasn't a setup.
You want to go rabat la content.
Nekiri. Nekiri. What did I say? What did I say?
I could read lips. Come on,
you must show him the video when we went. He was like, what's happening? Are we getting stuck?
No, he was like this.
What's
that? I got stuck. It's weird. All of a sudden, the GoPro is set up. The tripod. Come on.
What kill did it have? How big was that leopard?
Look, it's very deadly.
I wish I had seen it, man.
It has been good to you.
It's been a good day. Full of adventure, full of everything.
No regrets.
Got suspicions. You guys set me up. I got that. What a nice line. Can't blame yourself. You guys set me up. Why did you choose that line?
I can't see. Who could see?
Yeah, that's a gentleman's thing. That's the Meerkat way. That we love one another irrespective. It's a bit of car trouble. There's a lot of noise. We went through a big mud puddle and the rancher just started making funny sounds. So I'm gonna try and drive next to Judah. So that he can listen and pick up what kind of noises we try to look around, there's nothing that we see. So well, I say it, I know. Maybe never to reverse.
You go like it's hell like I'm at.
Hmm. What did you have? What did you make this shit? It's quiet. Huh? Oh, there we go. Trying to change direction of, and hopefully the, but the sound is gone after I reversed, the sound is subsided, so it looks like we're good to go. I think we got Katama, we can go. So we slept at Audi camp in Maun, and the gentlemen are checking the effects of yesterday. Engines are white, preparing for the journey. This is Audi camp in Maun. So from Moremi we came here late at night and arrived here around 10 o'clock. Fortunately the guys were able to open the gate for us, and we managed to lodge in, set up camp, have something to eat, and then get to bed. So this is, it goes in quite deep in there. They've got tented camps and ablutions, and there's gallery and toilets and everything. So it's a beautiful place. Yeah, it's been a couple of hours without content, eh? We've had a nightmare of a day. Nightmare of a day. I'm not gonna even get into it, but yeah, it's been fun and games. It's been fun and games. So we're on our way to Rakops. And maybe talk about this another time, but yeah, we left Maun around 7 o'clock. Breakdown after breakdown, replace alternator, replace pulleys, engine knocks. Fun and games. You are what?
It didn't even want to.
Come here. I want you on the light. Come here. What come here. Want? Come here. What's happening? Okay, let me do this. Here's the light. sorry. Let's put it down.
Yeah, no, Mufasa had some mechanical issues. We are slowly towing him to wherever. We'll see where we get. I'm with my brothers here from Meerkat Squad. I've got Sigos the Adventurer, I've got Stivoski, and our brother from another mother in Botswana, Tlamelo. But let me tell you, Moremi went and wild. I am Dagi gone wild. I will not be tamed. I am back. But yeah,
yeah,
I'll be here. I'm still wilding non-stop.
Yeah.
Even if it means I have to have a backpack of an engine.
It's been hectic.
We wake up at what time?
6 o'clock.
No. At five thirty.
Yeah.
To pack up to leave.
Yeah.
And we couldn't leave.
We're still here.
We started the engines and
things didn't go to play. And the engines were not speaking the language.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're still in Botswana.
But it happened.
Hmm. What time is it now? Like 9 o'clock? What is it?
I don't know.
What time is it?
It's now 9 o'clock.
And we are 75 k's away from Maun. We're meant to leave at 6 o'clock in the morning. And we barely moved in relative terms because we are 1,100 kilometers away from home. Started the day looking forward to getting home. By this time, we're supposed to be getting home. By this time. And this didn't happen. And now here we are. We left Maun at 7 o'clock. So we left Maun 11 hours later than what we intended. And it's dark. We're on our way to Rakops. We've booked a campsite there. We're gonna camp. We haven't eaten lunch. We haven't eaten supper. But yeah, it's been a hell of a day. Yesterday was fun. Yesterday was hella fun, man. Yesterday was awesome. Today was one of those days where a lot of lessons were learned. Yeah, we learned a lot of things today. It was just lessons day. And I think the experience that we gained, it becomes an invaluable experience for future trips. On what to do in breakdowns and what not to do. So we learned a lot. We're going home. We are happy. Everybody is in positive moods. We're playing the radio. Yes, one vehicle is in tow. We are fine. Our spirits are okay. Not happy of the experience. We're late and everything. Yes, money was spent unnecessarily from all the repairs, making frames. You can imagine. So, yeah, that wasn't something that we, you know, you enjoy or look up to and look forward to. But it was done, and because we're at a point where we feel that we've won the battle. And we're going home. We're happy about that, and that's something to look forward to. We're coming back here in June, and if you want to join us, come and join us and have fun. And if you break down, we break down, and we get home, irrespective. We get home, and we'll get home. And that's us, that's the Meerkat, and that's the Meerkat way.
When you go, it's not going where the light is, it's going to be up very low. It's not very high up. But I think it's the design, the game frame is too wide. That's why I went one side to go up and the other side.
Good morning. It will be good morning tomorrow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna get one of those.
We are generally in good spirits and heading home, filling up tanks for the rest. Gone Wild is sorted and wilding again.